Wheat is one of the most essential ingredients ever cultivated. From bread to pastries, this humble grain is at the heart of countless recipes. But before it reaches your kitchen as flour, it undergoes a fascinating transformation process that turns harvested wheat into the fine white powder we all know. Have you ever wondered what happens to those wheat grains after they're harvested? In this video, we'll show you the advanced techniques and precision involved in transforming raw wheat into the most widely used powder in kitchens around the world. The journey to flour begins with the wheat harvest, a critical step in the production process. Farmers closely monitor the wheat, looking for visual signs like the color of the grains and leaves, and conducting moisture tests to ensure the crop is ready for harvest. Once the wheat is at its peak, the harvester springs into action, gliding through the fields as sharp blades slice the stalks near their base. These freshly cut stalks are swiftly gathered and fed into the machine, marking the first step in the wheat's transformation. Inside the harvester, the wheat stalks undergo threshing, where powerful blades and rollers work to separate the grains from the leftover plant material. Through a combination of screening and ventilation systems, the harvester efficiently removes impurities, ensuring only the cleanest grains are collected. These clean grains are then directed into a storage tank within the harvester. Once the tank is full, the harvested wheat is transferred into trailers, ready for its next journey. After harvesting and separating the wheat from straw and other unwanted materials, it's crucial to store and transport it properly to maintain its quality. The wheat grains are carefully loaded onto trucks and transported to storage silos for further processing. These storage facilities are thoroughly inspected to ensure they are clean and in perfect condition, free from pests, excess moisture, and other potential threats that could compromise the wheat's quality. Proper storage is essential to prepare the wheat for its next transformation into flour. When the trucks loaded with harvested wheat arrive at the storage facilities, the process of quality control begins. A grain probe immediately takes samples from the entire shipment to assess its quality. Key details such as the wheat's origin and moisture content are recorded. If the wheat has higher moisture levels than normal after harvest, it undergoes a drying process to reduce moisture to optimal levels for long-term storage. This ensures the wheat remains in peak condition for its journey to the milling process. After evaluating the wheat samples for quality and moisture content, the wheat is carefully blended to ensure even moisture distribution and prevent spoilage. The trucks then deliver the wheat to an underground conveyor belt, which transports it to the silos. Here, the wheat is unloaded and stacked in layers, compacted to optimize space and maintain its quality. The silos are equipped with advanced ventilation and temperature control systems to keep the wheat in ideal conditions, ensuring it remains fresh and ready for the next stage of processing. Once the wheat is safely stored, it undergoes a thorough cleaning process. During storage, the wheat can accumulate impurities like stones, dust, and other foreign grains. To address this, a series of specialized machines, including vibrating screens, sifters, and magnetic separators, are used to remove these contaminants. The wheat then enters a cleaning machine, where a set of sieves filters out more impurities, such as straw, sticks, and grain dust. This thorough cleaning is crucial for ensuring the wheat is free of unwanted materials and ready for the milling process. The next step involves carefully blending different wheat varieties to create the desired type of flour. After mixing, the wheat undergoes a second, more thorough cleaning process designed to remove smaller impurities like weed seeds and fine dust. It then enters the milling machine where it is evenly distributed to ensure that each grain is processed efficiently. As the wheat heads towards the milling machines, a scale monitors the production quantities. The mill's vertical production line rises 5 stories high, with gravity guiding the wheat through a series of milling stages. The goal is to produce white flour by grinding only the wheat's inner endosperm, while separating out the bran, the tough outer layer, and the germ. The process begins as soon as the wheat grains enter the first milling machine. Here, steel rollers crush the grains, and sieves sort the particles. Particles that are too large to pass through the sieve move on to the next machine, continuing the process until the desired consistency is achieved. The wheat travels through a series of rotating rollers with varying gaps between them. These rollers break and crush the grain, allowing its different parts to be separated. The specific configuration of the rollers and the pressure applied determine the type of flour produced. The milling process divides the wheat into three main parts: the endosperm, bran, and germ. The endosperm, the grain's inner section, is rich in starch and is refined into flour. The bran, the grain's outer layer, is packed with fiber and nutrients and is used to create whole wheat flour. The germ, which contains oils and essential nutrients, can be extracted and utilized for producing oil or dietary supplements. As the rollers separate the germ and bran, they crush the endosperm into granular pieces known as semolina. Sieving removes the germ and any loose bran, but many semolina particles still carry bran residues. To address this, each milling station is equipped with a purifier that uses controlled air currents to lift the lighter bran particles away from the heavier semolina. This process of milling and purifying is repeated multiple times until the semolina is entirely free of bran. Only then is the semolina finally ground into flour through a series of sieves, ensuring it leaves the final milling machine as a smooth, powdered flour. After milling, the flour fractions are sifted and classified by size and quality to ensure the desired consistency. This process involves passing the flour through sieves with different mesh sizes to separate fine particles from coarser ones. Finer sieving removes smaller particles like flour dust, resulting in a smooth, uniform texture and preventing any coarse particles from reaching the final product. As a result of the milling process, the flour mill generates three primary products: bran, white wheat flour, and wheat germ. The bran, the coarse outer layer of the wheat grain, is rich in fiber and nutrients, making it valuable for animal feed and whole grain baking. White wheat flour, produced from the endosperm, is the refined flour commonly used in baking and cooking. Wheat germ, the nutrient-dense core of the grain, is utilized in the health food market for its rich content of vitamins, minerals, and healthy fats. Any remaining byproducts, including smaller fragments of bran and endosperm, are repurposed as animal feed, ensuring minimal waste and efficient use of resources. In the mill's quality control laboratory, the flour is put to the test by baking products that match its intended use. Experts evaluate the baked goods for appearance, texture, and flavor to ensure they meet quality standards. Specialized equipment measures key attributes such as volume, density, protein content, and moisture levels. Just before packaging, the mill strengthens its white flour with added vitamins and minerals to replenish those lost during milling. This enrichment process ensures that the final product retains its nutritional value. After thorough processing, sifting, and quality verification, the flour is packaged and prepared for distribution. The bags are shaken to settle the flour and checked to make sure they are clean and properly sealed. Sometimes these individual packages are grouped into larger boxes for easier transport. The flour bags, packaged in various sizes, are distributed to supermarkets, restaurants, and commercial bakeries, while tanker trucks transport bulk flour to large industrial bakeries. If you want to know how chocolate is made, watch the video on your screen, and please like the video if you enjoyed it and share it with someone who might be interested. Also, subscribe to this channel by activating the notifications to continue learning. Thanks for watching.